I joined the Community Foundation Board a couple of years ago, that we didn't have a really good connection with the organizations in the community, and then we formed the Board of Advisors, and I'm really happy about that. Maybe you could just mention why you think it's important that we have that group.
Well, Eileen, the Board of Advisors is really important to us because representing our community can only be done well when we really hear what their needs are, and when we hear their successes, we know what areas they still have needs that we can help them with. They are the primary providers for us of grant requests, and those grant requests are reviewed, and grants are made by us every spring and every fall. Those grants are made for very specific purposes to benefit specific members and groups of our community at our Thanksgiving luncheon and again at our Pathway of Pride reception in the spring.
Well, I think it's great because we can do the job of helping raise the money, and they can do the important thing of doing all that great work.
Exactly.
Bob, everyone who knows you knows that you have a very special place in your heart for the Rancho Bernardo Community Foundation and the community that it serves. And you've been on this board now for longer than any of the other current members. Could you give us your perspective on how it started and how it got to be where it is today?
Eileen, that's a good question, and I'd be happy to answer. I am the only original board member left on the foundation. There were five of us originally appointed by the community council in order to have an entity that would be a tax-deductible organization for people wanting to give to the community for a project. And in those days, the project was an emergency map of Rancho Bernardo. Once that was accomplished, the thought was, how can the foundation really be of service to the community? And at one night at 2 a.m. in the morning, when I had nothing else to think about, it dawned on me that we might be able to build the endowment of the foundation and give people recognition by putting plaques in the park, in the sidewalk at Webb Park. And I went to the Town Center Association, who operates the park, and they were most helpful and has allowed us over the years to rip up sidewalk and implant these granite plaques with people's names on it who have donated at least $1,000 to the community. That means we've got well over $100,000 so far donated to the endowment because of the Pathway of Pride.
Well, thank you for all you've done to make the history and the future of Rancho Bernardo terrific.
Well, you're most welcome, and I've had a ball. Rancho Bernardo is the greatest place in the world to live.
One of the most popular foundation events is the Community Thanksgiving Luncheon. Dee Dee, would you tell us about that?
Half of the proceeds from the Thanksgiving luncheon go into the endowment fund for future projects in Rancho Bernardo, and the other half are given out each year in grants to community organizations that help make Rancho Bernardo such a special place to live.
The signature project of the Rancho Bernardo Community Foundation is the Rancho Bernardo Historical Society's efforts to get a permanent museum for the artifacts which maintain our history. How did that get to be such an important project for the foundation?
Good question, Eileen. I believe that we have such a deep sense of history here in Rancho Bernardo that when the Rancho Bernardo Historical Society president, Kathy Serpas, came to us and put in a grant to help them start a fund for their permanent location, we looked at this as a real way of making a meaningful, long-lasting contribution to our community. Since then, it has really sparked the interest of many people in town, and I believe we're well on our way to helping them get a good start.
Daryl, I know it's a source of pride that you and I are both represented on the Pathway of Pride here by Webb Lake, and I know I'm very proud of my being here, and I know you are too, but maybe you could share why you're here, why your name is here.
Well, I'd heard of the Pathway of Pride, but I really knew very little bit about it, and I got involved with the RB Community Foundation and found out that it was its primary source of fundraising. And that interested me. And as I spent some time in the foundation, I suggested that there be more other ways of raising money besides the Pathway of Pride, but it ought to be maybe a central basic theme of the foundation's fundraising prowess. We went then from the Pathway of Pride to the community Thanksgiving luncheon and all other ways that we raise money. And to me, the Pathway of Pride was just one way of people and residents in RB of expressing their appreciation for the community and being recognized on the Pathway of Pride. So each of us who give here encourages others to give. I think I asked and got 16 other people to contribute to the Pathway of Pride. So it's really not that difficult.
And it's been a great place to live in Rancho Bernardo.
It surely has.
I was at a luncheon for the foundation. It was a master's ceremony that particular day, and I had closed the meeting, or thought I had closed the meeting, when the manager of the home savings had suggested she had something to say, and she got up and she told the audience that she wanted to be the first and buy the first Pathway of Pride plaque for me as the community representative for Home Savings of America.
Well, first of all, we have lived here 23 years and we've never missed an Independence Day or a Memorial Day celebration right here in Webb Park. This is America. This is the American scene. And we're just so pleased to be part of it. It's part of our whole family's approach towards America. Now, Rancho Bernardo, we see it as the jewel of Rancho of all of San Diego. And to be part of the Pathway of Pride, we see people who feel like we do, that Rancho Bernardo is that jewel. And it's an honor, sincerely an honor, to be part of that and to contribute to hold the Rancho Bernardo flag high. God bless America and Rancho Bernardo.
Well, you know, your contribution will make sure that all those events that were so important to you will go on forever and ever. Joyce, I know that your husband's plaque is going to be in the very next group in the spring when the Community Foundation does its Pathway of Pride celebration. And I know you've chosen to participate in his memory for very special reasons. So maybe you could tell us a little bit about that.
We walked this path. We walked this path for many, many, I can't tell you how many times. When people would come to visit us, we'd come here. We'd bring them here and show them that here in this very large city, we had this piece of, we used to call it this little paradise, you know, with the water and the paths. And it takes a lot to maintain this. And we enjoyed it so much. So when my husband died about 8 weeks ago, I made that decision that I wanted something for him here in memory, and as I say, I just can't tell you how much we enjoyed it.
You know, this Pathway of Pride is just such a wonderful thing, and the concept of an endowment just assures that it will always be a wonderful thing. A gift of $1,000 today generates $50 every year. And it doubles by the time, more than doubles by the time 20 years have gone by. And I know that those 20 years go by much faster than any of us want them to. And we've all enjoyed that much time here. And there will be people who follow us who will, I hope, have as wonderful experience as we have. And just be assured, there's a place for you on this Pathway of Pride to help make this community stay as wonderful as it has always been for all of us.